works on the range. And his horse and his cattle are his only companions. He sits in the saddle and he sleeps in the canyons, waiting for summer, his pastures to change. And as the moon rises, he sits by the fire, thinking about women and glasses of beer, closing his eyes as the doggies retire. He sings out a song which is soft but is clear, as if maybe someone might hear. Good night, ye moonlight ladies, rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me into your eyes? Yeah, rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Now the first of December was covered with snow, and so was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. And the Berkshire seemed dreamlike on account of bad frosting. With 10 miles behind me and 10,000 more to go, there's a song that they sing when they take to the highways, a song that they sing when they take to the seas, a song that they sing from their home in the skies. Maybe you can believe it if it helps you to sleep, but the singing works just fine for me. Good night, you moonlight ladies, rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me come into your dreams and rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Thank you. Ali and I will do actually, it's a very overdone song, but I've not heard it in St. Andrews for a long time. You'll all know it's a Ralph McTell song, which gives it away. And you can all join in and, you know, sing the chorus and whatnot. Try and all join. It's a bit early in the night, I know, but you're most welcome to join in. Sing along with us. Is it on then? Yeah. Anyway, here we go, at last. Have you seen the old man in the closed down markets, kicking at the papers with his worn out shoes? In his eyes you see no pride, his hands held loosely by his side, yesterday's papers telling yesterday's news. So how can you tell me you're lonely, or say for you that the sun don't shine? Let me take you by the hand and I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. Well, have you seen the old girl who walks the streets of London, dirt in her hair and her clothes all in rags? She's no time for talking, she just keeps right on walking, carrying her home in two carrier bags. And how can you tell me you're lonely, or say for you that the sun don't shine? Let me take you by the hand and I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your mind. Well, in the all-night cafe at 11:15, same old man sitting there on his own, looking at the world over the rim of his teacup. Well, each tea lasts an hour and he wanders home alone. Everyone, come on. So how can you tell me you're lonely? I'll say for you that the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand and I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your la 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 la. Have you seen the old man outside the seaman's mission? Memories fading like the medals that he wears. In our winter city, the ring cries a little pity for one forgotten hero and a world that doesn't care. Everyone now, and how can you tell me you're lonely? I'll say for you that the sun don't shine. Let me take you by the hand and I'll lead you through the streets of London. I'll show you something to make you change your la 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 la. Thank you. Here's another one you'll all know, and you're most welcome to join in too. Good chorus. When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care, and nothing, oh, nothing is going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, everyone, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, hey, now all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I will. You've got a friend. If the sky above you should turn dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud, and soon you'll hear me knocking upon your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, well, hey, now all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I will. Now, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend? When people can be so cold, well, they'll hurt you and desert you. Well, they'll take your soul if you let them. Whoa, but don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, you know, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I will. You've got a friend. Thank you. Here's a Rob Noakes song. A lot of you will know it, and you're, again, most welcome to join in. Everything is getting brighter now. Everything is getting straight. But you know, I must think twice right now. In fact, it's getting quite late. And I must take my leave of you now. There's someone I gotta see. There's no more that I can give to you now, because somebody counts on me. Sleepy mornings in the summertime, you have been good to me, it's true. Sit here any longer now. There's more to summer days than you, and I must take my leave of you now. There's someone I gotta see. There's no more that I can give to you now, because somebody counts on me. What news to bring me, or what songs you have to sing, or what goods you have to sell me, or the reasons I pray. Well, now must take my leave of you now. There's someone I gotta see. No more that I can give to you now, because somebody counts on me. So when all my work is over, and when all my songs are sung, and there's nothing left to bother me, I'll do some counting in return, everyone. So I must take my leave of you now. There's someone I gotta see. There's no more that I can give to you now. Somebody counts on me. So I must take my leave of you now. There's someone I gotta see. There's no more that I can give to you now. Somebody counts on me. Thank you.
It's my new glasses. Can you see? Brings me to the point, by the way, having heard a Rab Noakes song, Billy Anderson has now got an ample supply, in fact he's got more than he needs, of Rab's new record, Red Pump Special, which everybody seemed to be looking for. He got them in and he's now got them. So if you want Red Pump Special, Billy Anderson's shop has got plenty of them. Having said that, our guest of the evening, would you welcome back to the St. Andrew's Club, please, John Watt and Davey Stewart.
Three men for quarantine, they went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine and a bottle of wine went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine, they went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine and a bottle of wine and five with bine went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine, they went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine and a bottle of wine and five with bine and a black greyhound duck called Bob went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine, they went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine and a bottle of wine and five with bine and a black greyhound duck called Bob for up were close went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine, they went to join the parish. Three men for quarantine and a bottle of wine and five with bine and a black greyhound duck called Bob for up were close up the back stairs went to join the parish. And it was shut. All right, folks.
The new Tay Road Bridge, finest in the country. Off a croon to cross it and it does nae raise a cheer. It's a bob to cross a Mersey, can stuff it up your jersey. Would they pay it down in London in a bloody fair? Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See a bonny pet bang standing in a row.
The Rothes Colliery, finest in the country. When Lizzie came to open it, they didn't let her see. It was half full of water, but ach, it doesn't matter. Plenty jobs at Cadco's making sausages for tea.
Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See the bonny pet bang standing in a row. St. Andrew's Beaches, finest in the country. If you like sewage, floating round your tolls. It's the Costa that he snooks enough to mack your bloody puke. If you want to go in for a duke, yeah, he had your nose. Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See the bonny pet bang standing in a row.
Fife's entertainments, finest in the country. We're the boys to come to if you want to get some tips. There's football at Central Park, necking birdies in the dark. Haggis, suppers, hot pies, bingo and chips.
Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See the bonny pet bang standing in a row. New Fife's got culture, finest in the country. Oh, when it comes to arty talk, oh, we're not the mugs. We've got chink nags on our was, a wheen of gonks in our haws. Vernon Ward, Tretchy Coffin, White Wally Dogs. Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See the bonny pit bang standing in a row.
The Cadco Peggery, finest in the country, subsidised by everyone, including you and me. Oh, George Sanders Bacon, I'll bet his back was aching. Send him back to Hollywood and string him for a tree.
Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See a bonny pit bang standing in a row. The Rosyth Dockyard, finest in the country. If you want a cushy job, just working for the state. For there's old folks and blind folks and holiday inclined folks. And if you want a submarine, just hurl it out the gate. Oh, Fife's got everything, just a place for tourists. See a bonny pit bang standing in a row.
Thank you. Just in case you hadn't gathered by this time, on my left is Davey Stewart. My name is John Watt, and this is my guest night. And we'd now like to sing a song, which... control
Wait
yourself,
till I've
madam.
Sung it.
Please,
I mean,
control yourself. Please control yourself.
Might not be good, you know.
No, no. We don't usually expect that so early in the evening. Later on, you know, it gets like that, but... stay with us and you never know what might happen, girls. Right. You all right? Yes. We're going to sing a serious song now here. Okay, this is a song called Pit and Weem Joe, and it's got a chorus if you want to sing it.
How about this one, Josh?
Yes, that looks nice. I can use that one. Oh, they're coming in all sides. Oh, God's sakes.
It's like Kissinger's last press conference, bigger.
Don't know about Kissinger's last press conference. Oh. Yeah. Reminds me of when I was in Nashville.
I'm gone wi' a lass frae Pittin Weem. She's every fisher laddie's dream. She guts the herring down by the quay and saves her kisses just for me. Pittin Weem, Pittin Weem. She's every fisher laddie's dream. She guts the herring down by the quay and saves her kisses just for me. Oh, last July, it came to pass, I met this bonny fisher lass, wearing sae blue and black her hair. I met her down at Ainster Fair. Pittin Weem, Pittin Weem, she's every fisher laddie's dream. She guts the herring down by the quay and saves her kisses just for me. I says to her, can I take you home? She says, oh fine, I ken your game, but nevertheless you're awfully kind. In fact, I wouldn't really mind. Pittin Weem, Pittin Weem, she's every fisher laddie's dream. She guts the herring down by the quay and saves her kisses just for me. I took her home that Saturday night. The moon was shining all so bright, and as we lay there on the grass, I says, hey Joe, would you be my lass? Pittin Weem, Pittin Weem, she's every fisher laddie's dream. She guts the herring down by the quay and saves her kisses just for me. She's my lass new and will I ken. She doesn't gang wi' other men, for I was quick where they were slow, and that's how I won my Pittin Weem, Joe. Pittin Weem, Pittin Weem, she's every fisher laddie's dream. She guts the herring down by the quay and saves her kisses just for me. Where Teresa has took up rajudol. She's been at it for 2 or 3 weeks, she would laugh at a Japanese jacket. In her white pair of Japanese breeks, she comes bringing him after each lesson with a new way to flatten a man. And the head fella says she's improving. Her that's him she keeps calling Black Dannon. She wants me to be her opponent. She gets mad when I don't take her on. She says, see you, you wee bochel, I can melt you with just a one horn. So, last night as we went to our scratcher, I was reaching to pit out the light when she stood up in bed like a margin and said, come on, Bobby, let's fight. Well, I got her down after a struggle. I can tell you the victory was sweet, and she says she prefers it to judo, but she called me a dirty wee cheat.
A long time ago, not a long time ago, but about 3 years ago, Davey and I, in combination with about 7 other people, went all around Scotland with a a party which we called the Great Fife Roadshow. And it was a great sort of concept, you know, we got a caravan, we got a Land Rover, we got about three cars. We used up about, oh, got about 200 gallons of petrol, and we played in front of about, I think, about 5,000 people, and we ate about 200 fish suppers, and we made absolutely no money whatsoever at the end of the day. In fact, we worked for another year to pay off the debts of it. But we, one thing that came out of it was we had a Christmas party, and this was at a place called Torbane, above Kirkcaldy, and this is how our Christmas party went. Did you hear of our Christmas party? It was planned with precision and zeal, and our cordon bleu, young Artie, had prepared a fantastic meal. There was LSD soup on the table, and tureens of instant smash, a choice of six veg for those able, and were turkey with stuff full of hash. Paper hats were for all who attended. Oh my, what a wonderful nicht, and where broken gas meter was mended, always bathed in a bricht cheerful licht. 'Twas a nicht for joyous confusion. There was all that a buddy could need, and the crackers lay round in profusion, stuffed with bennies, conundrums, and speed. Well, we was just about into the turkey, where glasses were charged with VP, when out of the dark, black and murky, come a howl just like a banshee. "Hey, boys," cried Santa the Fuzz, and he snecked out his joint on the chair, while Jim, was he'd was all buzz, flicked the bennies under the stair. Oh my, we were on a state. This had realised the worst of our fears, while bubbly Jock lay there on his plate, reeking like a nicht in the town of Algiers. "Open up in the name of the law, we'll put an end to your tear," and a great big Alsatian with slavering jaw come rocketing out of the flare. We just stood there, resigned to our fate, condemned by that grass-laden bird, for to hide it was new far too late. The police would hear the last word. Well, they searched us, and they went through our things. They were laughing, for they kent we were fear. Then they turned us, and jings, our turkey had clean disappeared. Had our grass-laden bird taken flight? We just stood there and rubbed it wherein. Was it winging its way through the night, bound for Paisley or Aberdeen? The inspector, he went clean off his skull. "What ken you've got drugs sitting here? We've followed you boys for Elgin to Mull. Sergeant Williamson, put down that beer." All left was a smashed pane of glass and a wee bit of string on the sill, or a bird that was stuffed full hash that was winging its way o'er the hills. Well, the police departed Guy Seek, and the Alsatian, it started to greet, for it kent pretty certain next week that they'd all be back pounding the beat. Well, that's who our miracle came. At Christmas, one bright starry night, and often we think in our cosy wee hame, o' jockey's incredible flight. There's a guy in Glasgow. Good? Another guitar. Grand. Ah, Mr. Robin McKidd. There's a guy in Glasgow called Adam McNaughton who writes really nice songs. And he writes them about Glasgow and about the people of Glasgow and about the situations that develop in Glasgow. And the type of humour he's sort of talking about is similar to a type of humour that a guy called Bud Neil, who used to live in Dunfermline, had. I don't know if any of you remember the cartoons of Bud Neil, but he used to have cartoons in the Daily Express. And he used to live out the Holbeath Road past the football park at Dunfermline. And one of Bud Neil's sort of, I think, sort of epic cartoons which epitomised Glasgow humour was this cartoon of a big fat woman, and she's standing at Partick Cross there, and there's this guy passing her, and he's got masses of long hair, and he's got beads and everything, and this big fat woman's saying to this boy, "Oh, so you're a poet, son. Well, you've got a broad day for it." And that's the kind of thing that Adam's talking about. Think about it. And he calls it, "Where is the Glasgow?"
Oh, where is the Glasgow where I used to stay? With white wally closes done up with pipe clay, where you knew all your neighbours from first floor to third, and to keep your door locked was considered absurd. Oh, do you know the folk living upstairs for you? And what are the wains that once played in the street? We a jarry or a peery or a gird, we a cleat. Could they catch a hudgy? Could they dreep off a dyke? Or is writing none was new the one thing he likes? Could he tell Chickie Melly fae hunch, could he hunch? And what is the wee shop where I used to buy a quarter o' tatties and a tuppenny pie, a bag o' broken biscuits and three soddy scones, and the woman I asked, who's your ma getting on? Can your big supermarkets give service like that? And what is the chip shop that I knew so well, and the wee corner cafe where they used to sell hot pie and brie and McCallum's and books, and you kent they were tallies the moment they spoke? Do you want a raspberry on your ice or a cream? And where is the football that I played and saw, and the fair shooter church and the wee tanner bow? There was nae 3-2-3, there was nae 4-2-4, and your mates didna kiss ye whenever ye scored. Is the game like Big Woodburn suspended signed aye? And what is that ram car that once in the ton up the Great Western Road on the old yoker run? The conductress I kent who to deal wi' a nyaff. If you're gone, then get on. If you're no, then get off. They're only like her on the buses the day. And where is the Glasgow that I used to know? Big Willie, wee Hughie, the steamy, the cool, the wee shelp at Buckle and the big lake at Dreep. Oh, the boys on the slates and your gas at a peep. If you scrape the veneer off, are these things still there? La 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 la.
John sometimes flies off into the realms of surrealistic fantasy when he's in the toilet, and he sometimes emerges with less weight than he went into in a song in his pocket. It's the strain of creation, I think. And this was one of John's songs that was created in such a manner. It's called Arabelle, Rosabelle. The tune's not original. You may know it.
Arabelle, Rosabelle, Jimison McGee, 16 stone of flesh and bone and only 23. Do I see her often? Yes, I do, sir. Every Friday at Rabrousser, all she gets, she hands it o'er to me. Arabelle, Rosabelle McGee, Arabelle, Rosabelle, hair like mouldy hay, feet like clugs, packet lugs, and in the family way.
plastic earrings, windy hanging, prams all washing, steaming, minging. Tells me that her love is here to stay. Arabelle, Rosabelle, McGee, where Greyhound Bob sits in her close and looks out for her. He knows that Arabelle knows all the tricks. We'll gee him a fix and then someday he'll be top dog. And then Arabelle and Bob and me will live just like the sheiks. That's Olani, 1,000 trannies and golden lamy breeks. Diamonds all around were kludgy. Electric blankets for were budgie. We'll change your motor car each 7 weeks. Arabelle, thank you, Rosabelle. Arabelle, thank you, Rosabelle. Arabelle, Rosabelle, Maggie. Sometimes songs are sung to death, and they should be. I mean, death's the best place for them. But sometimes, after a while, songs are worth reviving. I'm not sure whether this one is or ever was, but I'm going to sing it anyway. It's called Shoals of Herne. It was from a radio ballad by Ewan McCall, and it was sung to death and death and death and death. But I'm hoping to revive it. I hope not too many other people latch on, or it might spring to life again. It's called Shoals of Herne. You'll know it.
Oh, it was a fine and a pleasant day. Out of Yarmouth Harbour I was bearing, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger, for to hunt the bonny shoals o' Herne. Oh, we left the home ground in the month of June, and for canny shales we soon were bearing, way a hunder cran o' the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals o' Herne. Oh, we fished the swathe and the broken bank. I was cook and I'd a quarter sharing, and I used to sleep standing on me feet, and I dream about the shoals o' Herne. Well, you're up on deck, you're a fisherman, you can swear and show a manly bearing. Tack your turn on watch with the other fellows as you're following the shoals o' Herne. Well, I earned me keep and I paid me way, and I earned the gear that I am wearing. Sailed 10,000 miles, caught 1,000,000 fishes as we hunted for the shoals o' Herne.
First joke of the evening. As a boy goes to the vet with his dog. Are you listening? Sit down. As a boy, I think this is really great. I really killed myself when I heard this, first of all. I really did. I think you'll like it. As a boy goes to the vet with his dog, and he says to the vet, "This dog has lost its voice. It's got no bark, it's got no woof or anything." And the vet says, "Oh, we'll fix that up. Just bring it out to the garden." He says, "Out the garden?" He says, "Yes, just bring it out to the garden." So he takes it out to the garden, and the vet goes and he gets a gallon of petrol and he pours it over it, strikes a match, and the dog goes woof. No?
Oh, what a foolish joke. Yes. Oh, what a foolish joke.
All right. Here's a wee song. No, no, we can't tell another one. We can't sort of overload the sort of good things. They've all to come sort of later. That's the sort of cream in the cake and all that, you know. We can't have you sort of getting hysterical. Right. This is a song about a guy who wants to court a girl and he's frightened to do it himself, so he sends another guy to do it for him, and the other guy gets the girl, and the other guy's name happens to be McFarlane. So the name of the song is McFarlane or the Sprouts Boburnie Boozy.
Off for the Tybee to run, he's done this a while he been. I'd rather walk for here to burst with pace in both my shin. I'd rather dee for a winter breath and pine for a winter love. And it's all because McFarlane married Susie. Now Susie's cankered feather away, mine could never gree. And I, when I'd gang out that gate, he'd set his dug at me. So I sent my friend McFarlane round to see what he could dee. McFarlane, oh, the spots o' Burnie Boozy. I dinna like McFarlane, I'm safe enough to state. His lug would cast a shadow o'er a sack's foot gate. He's soft as only goblin, as sluddery as a skate. McFarlane, oh, the spruts o' Burnie Boozy. McFarlane spak nae word for me, but plenty for himsel. He raised the lassie's barley scones, her kibbaca and her kale, till her feather cried out, "Sprutty man, you should try your luck yoursel." To McFarlane, oh, the spruts o' Burnie Boozy. Now McFarlane is the grimmest cheel for 20 mile aroon. They use his photograph to flag the rotten's fae the toon. He kittled up his spunk at this, and speared gin she come doon. Be the mistress o' the spruts so Burnie Boozy. I dinna like McFarlane, I tell ye it's a fact. He's a nace for splitting hailstones and a humpy back. His legs like gutta perca, ilka step his knees gang knack. McFarlane, oh, the spruts o' Burnie Boozy. He said that he was able both to play at cout the ladle. We led her o'er a trickle cask and caw the churn for by. Another o' his winners was that sawdust mixed with sinners was the spice for feeding hens at Burnie Boozy. Now an educated ostrich for the zoo at Timbuktu, he had for scratting up his neeps but hadn't them to poo. I never seen the like of that come out o' any moo, but McFarlane o' the spots o' Burnie Boozy. I dinna like McFarlane, I tell ye, oh, it's true. A pewter spin with stint and joke McFarlane's moo. He couldna well be grimmer, sups his bros with the skimmer. McFarlane, oh, the spruts o' Burnie Boozy. Noo, a diddle, oh, the teethache's nae particularly sweet, but love's the only pain on earth that ever got me greet. It's like it, the chilblains ruin your heart instead of ruin your feet. They were aggravated way the sight of Susie. Now friends and kind philosophers, oh, hear what me befell. Never lip him to the middle man, but do your work yourself, or I'll bet my hen was circuit, you're a day I hint the market, as when I said McFarlane round to Susie. Now I dunna like McFarlane, and I'm fairly half o' joke. I dunna like McFarlane nor McFarlane's folk. May Susie be nae turtle, but bring the tongs or Sparto, do now the heed do Jocko Burnie Boozy.
We'll finish this half with a rousing political song written 200 years ago by Robert Burns. It's called The Man's the Man for All That. If you know it, join in. If you didn't know it, join in the bits that you know. It changes every other verse, unfortunately, or every verse, unfortunately, at the end.
Is there for honest poverty what hangs the seed and all that? The coward slave we pass him by, we dare be poor for all that. For all that and all that,
where toil's obscure and all that. The rank is but the guinea stamp, the man's the gout for all that. With though unhimly fair we dine, we're hard and grey and all that. Gie fools their silks, gie knaves their wine, a man's a man for all that. For all that and all that, their tins so show and all that. The honest man, though e'er sae poor, is king o' men for all that. Ye see yon Berkey, he's cried aloud, what struts and stares and all that. Though hunters worship at his word, he's but a coof for all that. For all that and all that, his ribbon star and all that. The man, no independent mind, he looks and laughs at all that. A prince can mock a belted knight, a marquis, duke and all that. The honest man's up in his might, get faith in monarch for that. For all that and all that, their dignities and all that. The pith o' sense and pride o' worth are higher rank than all that. So let us pray that come it may, as come it will for all that. That sense and worth o'er all the earth shall bar the grief for all that. For all that and all that, it's coming yet for all that. That man to man the hill world shall brothers be for all that.
Here we are again. Last time for 4 months. Aren't you lucky? Pardon? I've decided to sing one of my favourite songs. South African song. Oh, I thought that'd get somebody. I remember the time I was driving along on the Liverpool highway, singing this song. The day it was good as the day it was long, I was on my own. Then up ahead, a black speck appeared, and as I drew near, it was just what I'd feared. Doing 25 miles an hour in top gear in the outside lane. Deary me, glory be, what was it I could see? It was a red velvet steering wheel cover driver. He and his wife sat side by side in their safety belts. They were safely tied as they drove together through the green countryside, which they could not see. Deary me, glory be, one of them I could see. It was was a red velvet steering wheel cover driver. He's got three china ducks on his living room wall, and a bunch of pink plastic flowers in the hall, and a souvenir ashtray he bought in Porthcawl on his holiday. When he gets home, he goes straight to his chair, turns on the telly, and all night he stares at the girls and the gunfights and wishes he was there, but he's here to stay. When he regrets what he didn't see, then he turns to ITV, 'cause he's a red velvet steering wheel cover driver. Each Monday morning he takes his basket, goes downtown to the supermarket. He walks up and down and says, what a task, it's so hard to choose. Well, there's apple sponge pudding, all topped up with tasty freeze, ready sliced loaves, instant cake mix and frozen peas. All of those 57 varieties fresh today. So easy, just heat the tin. We'll think of the prizes you'll win if you're a red velvet steering wheel cover driver. Saturday night, our night for a fling, so on with our glad rags and hey, ring-a-ding. It's off to the hall for a nice game of bingo and cups of tea. Then it's back home to bed and turn out the light, hug a hot water bottle, sweet dreams and good night, and God save us from the things go bump in the night, and especially all the dreams of the day when our own children will say, my dad's a red velvet steering wheel cover driver.
Thank you. This one's an English song. Bit of an experiment, actually, because it's about the first one I've learnt for about 5 or 6 years. No, it can't have been, because I've only been playing the guitar for about 3. Well, it's a new song, anyway. It's all about a sailor who says he'll marry this girl, and he goes off sailing, and the boat capsizes, and he's washed up on the shore dead, and his bird's walking along the shore, and he sees her, and she thinks, oh. And she lies down, drops dead with him. Comes from Yorkshire.
Unstopro, unstopro. There a maid did dwell. She's loved a fish, a laddie. He's loved her quite as well. He said he would marry her when once he did return. Ah, but for cruel fortune lie on the raging main. And as they were a-sailing, sailing by night, the moon it was shining and the sky was dark as night. The storm, it was a-raging, and their ship was caught, and it blew those poor sailors all on that ragged shore. Now some of them were single, some of them had wives, but all of them had to swim for their very lives. This unfortunate sailor boy, he was not saved. Instead of being buried, he's found a watery grave. Now as she was a-walking from Stowbro' unto Bay, she's bound a sailor lad, all on the sand he lay. And nearer to him she's come, nearer to her stand. She spied it was her own true love from the mark on his right hand, and she's kissed him, kissed him, caressed him 1,000 times or more. Oh, these awful billows have blown my love ashore. And she's laid down beside him, she's laid down by his side. And in a few moments, she's kissed him and died. The couple were buried in Robin Hood's churchyard, and a memorial stone was raised all at their head. And to all of you lovers who do this way pass by, pray shed a tear of pity from your glistening eye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Andrew Jacobs. It gives me great pleasure now to... She can hold it down a bit. It gives me great pleasure now to welcome back to the St. Andrew's Club two people who are always very welcome in the St. Andrew's Club, High Speed Grass.
Well, it's really only half a High Speed Grass because Big Sid's not here tonight.
I'd like to say to Mandy, whose guitar I've got.
Did I borrow
thank
it?
Thank you. I thought it was somebody else's that I knew. I realised it was you all the time. First song's called Easy Come, Easy Go. It's got a nice chorus. It just goes easy come, easy go. It's all the same to me. What you never have, you never miss. That's how it ought to be. Easy come, easy go. My daddy, he said the same. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. If you're going to play that game.
So join in.
Well, I met her on a Monday and she stole my heart away. I took her home on Tuesday, we got wed that very day. But when I come home on Wednesday, she's in love with another guy. But I didn't swear or tear my hair. Here is the reason why. It's easy come, easy go. Yeah, it's all the same to me. What you never had, you never miss. That's how it ought to be. Easy come, easy go. And my daddy said the same. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. If you're gonna play that game. Now all them politicians, they never raised my hopes. Just going around the countryside, stirring up the folks, and giving me the lowdown on how I ought to think. Cause when it comes election day, I always vote to drink. Easy come, easy go. Yeah, it's all the same to me. What you never had, you never miss. That's how it ought to be. Easy come, easy go. And my daddy said the same. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. If you're gonna play that game. Some folks, they got money, while other folks, they got dreams. Well, me, I ain't got neither, cause neither's what they seem. And if I strike it rich someday and throw it all away, I won't get mad about what I just had. This is what I'll say. Easy come, easy go. Yeah, it's all the same to me. What you never had, you never miss. That's how it ought to be. Easy come, easy go. And my daddy said the same. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. If you're gonna play that game.
One, two.
I'm sitting down tonight because I'm... Not because I can't stand it, but I don't have a, I lost the strap for my guitar, you know?
Bottle and we'll drink it on the track, baby, never coming back. I can just imagine about 100 years ago. Old number 7 just steaming across the heaven with the 20 cars are rocking with the coal. Bring on the go down. You can have your car pretend you're fooling around. Spending my time on the open ground. Down by the Yukon, a railroad. Well, you can bring a bottle and we'll drink it on the track. Baby, never coming back. I can just imagine about 100 years ago. Old number 7 just steaming across the heaven with the 20 cars are rocking with the coal. I bet your mom and papa, baby, they'll never know. Stepping by the river where the woodchucks go. Down by the Yukon, a railroad. Thank you, the Yukon, a railroad. You're the hero of the Yukon, a railroad. Thank you.
Thank you.
Robin McKidd, David Craig, High Speed Grass. Our next singer is about to get a guitar back.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. And then we come to the ladies' part of the programme. Would you welcome, please, Mandy Briggs.
Thank you. Put me in a bit of a panic. I went out to get the guitar. Look, there's room back there with hundreds of them. And that's too high. It's bigger than me. And looked around and I thought, that's funny. Must be here somewhere because I left it there. Couldn't see it. And I thought, well, I know they have to get me drunk to come on, just a little bit, but surely I'm not suffering from DTs. But it's nerves. Last time, the first time I ever sang here, in fact, made all my friends promise not to come in. Well, about two of them. Well, one did. I got up here, I nearly fell off the stool first time, and he walked out. That was before I even started. Well, it seems to be a night for singing songs that have been sung to death or whatever. I've had Streets of London, Shores of Herring, so Blowing in the Wind.
Must a man walk down before you can call him a man? And how many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? And how many times must the cannonballs fly before
songs to try for the sun, quiet one.
We stood in the windy city, the gypsy boy and I. young, too young. I'm going to try for the sun. We huddled in the derelict building, and when he thought I was asleep, he laid his coat around my shoulders and huddled.
Well, I spin the discs and I do my thing. I don't play nothing and I sure can't sing. But one thing flat, I can have a ball. I can talk all day and say nothing at all, 'cause I'm a DJ. Well, some folk think that my head's too big, but that's put out by the fastest pigs. You see, they talk about this, talk about that, but there ain't really nothing under my hat, 'cause I'm a DJ. Well, I talk about politics, the current scene. Got my posters of Che and Steve McQueen. And the women are getting birds, they're chicks. And I smoke a little hash just to get some kicks, 'cause I'm a DJ. Well, I know all about horse and shit, and I've had VD, I've done my bit to use words like pow and groove and splat. I'm a super duper superficial motherfucking cat. Yippee, I'm a DJ.
Big hand for Robin McKidd.
Out in our backyard, my granny was sitting. She was humming and rocking and casually knitting when up to her front door came Big Jock McClelland, were local police force, and another man with him. Oh, no cries, my mither, my feather, Lord, save us. The local police forces come to enslave us, and my big brother Jim started cursing and spitting while out in her backyard my granny was knitting. Come on, says my feather, now tell us what's cooking. We're local police forces. Ach, we're just looking, and we're looking for drugs like heroin and morphia, and if we find any on you, we'll tack them up, waffy ya. Well, they looked in our kitchen, they raked in our midden, but they never yet found where our hemp was all hidden. And they looked in our lavvy, dismantled the bulk chain, but they never yet found even a trace of the cocaine. Came 5 o'clock, came 6 o'clock, and they both had to go away, but the local police force said he would get us all someday. Well, out in her backyard, my granny was sitting, cocaine in her needles. We hemp, she was knitting. A song about the time when people were poor. Me last week. And it was a time really when everybody was poor except the Hygieians, and they didn't like people doing anything bar working for them and sort of living on a pittance. And if you tried to get your rights by sort of poaching the land, the hares and the deers, it's your hares and deers just as much as your grannies is your grannies. The hares and the deers is your hares and deers. But it was called poaching in them day, and was very sort of serious offence. It's called The Poachers. It's got a great last verse. It's worth joining into. Last verse. Come all you gallant sports and boys that ramble void of care. When you go out on a moonlight night with your dog, your gun, your snare, the harmless hare and pheasant you have at your command, no thinking on your last career upon Bandyman's land. There was poor Tom Brown from Glasgow town, Jack Williams and poor Joe. We were three gallant sporting boys the country well did know. One night we were trepanned by keepers in the sand, and for 14 years transported unto Van Diemen's land. And the day on which we landed upon that fatal shore, the planters stood around us full 20 score and more, and they ranked us up like horses, and they sold us out of hand, and they yoked us to the plough, me boys, to plough Van Diemen's land. And the houses that we dwell in here are made of clot and clay, with rotting straw for bedding, we dare not say them nay. And our cots are fenced with wire, and we slumber when we can, and we fight the wolves and tigers which infest Van Diemen's land. But there came a lass, free sweet Dundee, Jean Stewart is her name. For 14 years transported for the stealing of the game, our captain bought her freedom, and he married her offhand, and she gives us all good usage upon Van Diemen's land.
Although the poor of Scotland do labour and do toil, they are robbed of every blessing and produce of the soil. Your proud, imperious landlords, if you break their command, they will send you to the British hulks or to Van Diemen's land.
Come, all you jolly sailors, and listen to my song. It's only 40 verses, so I'll not detain you long. It's all about the wanderings of this poor Lisburn tar that went on the sea, on the Lagan Canal, aboard of the Calabar. Now the Calabar was a clipper ship, copper fastened fore and aft. Her helmet stuck out far behind, and her wheel was a great big shaft. With half a gale to swell her sail, she could make 1 mile per hour. She's the fastest ship on the Lagan Canal, and only 1 horsepower. Now, the captain, he was a strapping lad. He stood full 4'2", and his eyes was green, and his nose was red, and his face was a Prussian blue. He wore a leather medal that he won in the Crimea War, and his wife was mate and passenger's cook aboard of the Calabar. Now the captain, he says to me one day, "Look here, my man," says he, "would you like to be a sailor and sail the raging sea? Would you like to be a sailor on foreign seas to roll? For I'm under orders for Portadown with half a ton of coal." Well, we left the Abercorn Basin, the weather it being sublime. And after we left the old Queen's Bridge, we heard the Albert chime. When coming to the gasworks there, a very dangerous part, we ran right onto a lump of coal that wasn't on the chart. Well, the rest was all confusion, and the stormy winds did blow. The captain slipped in an orange peel, fell into the hold below. All hands on deck, the first mate cried, for we were sore distressed. But the engineer from the bank replied, "The horse is doing its best." Well, a postman going to his work did hear us loudly roar, and he threw us the end of his gallows, and he hauled us safe ashore. I'll go no more a-wandering with all its stress and strain, and the next time that I go to Portadown, be Jesus, I'll go by train.
Okay, here's a recitation from Dunfermline. Now, Dunfermline, you maybe don't know, but I'm sure most of you know that Dunfermline at one time was one of the greatest linen-making centres in Europe.
Does somebody pay you to say that, John?
Concertina conscious. You see, Pelle's getting paid $13,000 for just kicking off a ball at the World Cup. That's all he has to do, and he's got a soft drinks sort of thing across him. However, that's nothing to do with this. Okay. In a mean abode down the Limekilns Road lived a man cried Charlie Groat, and he'd a wife the plague o' his life who continually got on his goat. To one day at morn, wi' her nich goon on, he slit her skinny throat. Wi' a razor gash, he settled her hash. Ha ha! Never was crime sae quick, but the steady drip on the pilly slip o' her lifeblood made him sick. While a pool of gore on the bedroom floor grew cold and clotted and thick. Well, he was glad that he'd done what he had, as his wife lay there so still. So to finish the fun so weel begun, he decided himsel to kill. So he's ta'en the sheet for her under cold feet, and he's knotted it into a rope.
and he's hanged himself for the lobby shelf. 'Twas an easy death, let's hope. While we his last breath, in the grips of death, he's uttered a prayer to the Pope. Now, the funniest turn of the whole concern, it's only just beginning. You see, Charlie went to hell, but his wife's new well. She's still alive and sinning. For you see, the razor blade was Japanese made, but the sheet was Dunfermline linen.
Now, if you see a funny looking chap, some folks thinks I dinna gie a rap. No, some folks thinks they're awfully clever, but they've mair need o' their mither. The other day a man came up to me and said, "Moan, you've a fine reed heed." I says, "Well, you hae any muckle hair yoursel', would you like some o' mine for seed?" "For I'm nae sae green as I may seem, if you think I'm soft as candy. Poke your fun at another silly gun, 'cause you canny put it on to Sandy." Now, you in such a theatre I never was before. I saw act one and I headed for the door. The doorman says, "Hang on, man, Sandy. Wait for the second act, more it's dawny." But in the programme which I had, this is what I read: 1 year will elapse between the acts. So I turned to him and said, "Oh, I'm nae sae green as I may see. Do you think I'm soft as candy? Let me sit here for a whole bloody year, though you canny put it on to Sandy." Now, yens, at a farm I was looking at some ducks. Along came this toff with a gun in the kerbox. Says he to me, "For one shot, Sandy, at these ducks here a pound what's handy." I said, "All right, there's a bit in my pooch." His shot killed 21. He said, "You'll be sorry I've killed some money." I said, "No, I've enjoyed the fun, for I'm nae sae green as I may seem. If you think I'm soft as candy, tack up your aim and fire a wot again, for they dinna belong to Sandy." Now, like other silly micks, I've got a wife wee. Live very happy and never have a strife, but weel I ken that my wife Bella, she gangs and coots with another fella, the Coleman. But I'm no an evil-minded chap, and I ken the game they play, 'cause just the other week I caught them out richting. "Her ain I had to say, oh, I'm nae sae green as I may seem. If you think I'm soft as candy, when you're off of him with your wife, I do the same. Oh, you canny put it on to Sandy." "We are the D-Day Dodgers, way out in Italy. We're always on the vino, we're always on the spree. We're 8th Army scroungers and we're tanks, and we live in Rome among the Yanks. A sartful D-Day Dodgers in sunny Italy. We landed at Salerno, a holiday with pay. The Jerry's brought their bands out to greet us on the way. They gave us some cakes and made us tea, and we all sang songs and the beer was free. To welcome the D-Day Dodgers to sunny Italy. Naples and Cassino, we took them in our stride. Ach, we didn't go to fight there, we just went for the ride. Anzio and Sangra were just names, and we only went to chat up dames. Och, the sartful D-Day Dodgers in sunny Italy. Dear Lady Astor, you think you know a lot. You're standing up in Parliament and sprouting Tommy Rot.
Your England's sweetheart and her pride, we think your mouth's too bloody wide. That's from the day the Dodgers in sunny Italy. Look upon the hillside in the mud and rain. See the scattered crosses, there's some that bear no name. Heartbreak and toil and suffering gone, the boys beneath them linger on. They are the dead Dodgers who stayed in Italy.
There's an old chap lives down our street in a cosy cottage green. And every Sunday morning when it's fine, oh, I often goes and sits with him to have a smoke and chat, because he is a dear old friend of mine. And when it's getting dinner time and dinner's ready then, well, I think it must be time for me to go. But he goes and hangs my hat up just behind the old front door, and then to my surprise I hear Jack say, oh, I'm always glad to see a man like thee. You're as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Draw your chair up to the table, stay as long as you are able, for I'm always glad to see a man like thee.
Let's hear you sing that then.
Oh, I'm always glad to see a man like thee. You're as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Draw your chair up to the table, stay as long as you are able, for I'm always glad to see a man like thee. One day as I was sat with him, there came a loud rat-tat. There came a loud rat-tat at Jack's front door. Well, he hurries over to open it, and there to his surprise, a hungry, tattered beggar stood outside. He asked Jack for a crust of bread. Jack looked him through and through. Well, bless your heart, he says, lad, come inside. And he goes and hangs his hat up just behind the old front door. Then to the tramp's surprise, he hears Jack say, oh, I'm always glad to see a man like thee. You're as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Draw your chair up to the table, stay as long as you are able, for I'm always glad to see a man like thee. Now when Jack had lived long enough, time came for him to die. He went upon the trams for one last ride, and he knocked upon the doors when he got up to the down sheds, and knocked upon the door and went inside. He held his hat within his hand, he says, I've come at last. St. Peter says, hey, Jack, I see it's thee. And he goes and hangs his hat up just behind the old front door. And then to Jack's surprise, St. Peter says, Oh, I'm always glad to see a man like thee. You're as welcome, lad, as welcome as can be. Draw your chair up to the table, stay as long as you are able, for I'm always glad to see a man like thee.
How long have we to go, Andy Cassidy? We've no watches here. We've got to do one more song.
Thanksgiving.
All right, yes. Well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for being so kind as to listen to us here tonight. And seriously, Funsters, it's been really marvellous coming back here to sing in Dundee again. Sorry, St. Andrews. Sorry, St. Andrews. Sorry. Right. Right. Okay. Oh, another joke we forgot to tell you. This is a creme de la creme. There's a wee boy, and it's another dog joke, and there's a wee boy, and he's with a teacher, and the teacher's shown him all sorts of dogs up on a wall on pamphlets and pointing to Alsatians and Dachshunds and long-haired, wire-haired terriers and that. And she says, what's that jog? What's that? No, dog. Not jog. What's that dog? What's that dog, Jimmy? And he says, oh, that's a coconut dog. He says, coconut dog? There's not such a dog as a coconut dog. Well, yes, miss, he says, when my father was walking down the street yesterday with his pal Willie, he said, hey, Willie, look at the coconut dog. No? Think on it.
Right.
Oh, wow, well, you can't win them all.
Kelty Clippy.
Look at the coconut dog.
Coconut.
Look at the coconut dog.
Everyone a coconut, right?
Right, we're doing Kelty Clippy.
Right, yes.
Right. All we need is a backing group for this one.
We need a backing group for this one. Is Robin McKidd there? This fantastic guitarist here.
And Davey Craig.
King. Davey Craig here, yes. Like King Lassie's answer to Liberace. Right. Yes, play guitar.
Here, I've got a story.
You've got a story,
this
right.
This is an absolutely true story. There's a fellow just now doing studies on trade councils in Glasgow. I don't know if you know trade councils, but they're sort of vaguely left-wing organisations. And he went along to this trades council meeting in Glasgow. And before the thing started, a wee bloke stood up in the front and he said, just before it starts, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a point of order. He says, there's somebody in the room tonight that's been making very serious allegations against me. He said, better not continue because me and my mates know who it is. And if it continues, there'll be serious repercussions against the bloke that's making them allegations and that, you know. So with that, a wee red-haired fella stood up in the back of the room and says, all right, yes or no, I'm the alligator.
See you later.
Oh, that sounds good. Keep going.
Right, this is Kelty Clippy. Yes, yeah. Oh, Kelty Clippy, oh! All right, football will never go to end.
I have travelled round this country, frae shore to shining shore, frae the swamps o' Ochter and Erin, tae the jungles o' Lahore. But in all these far-flung places, there's name that can compare with a lily o' Lumpin', and she's my bunny, Maggie Blair.
Fae the pyramids up in Kelty, tae Ross mansions in Glencraig. We've roamed the banks together on money's a blistra vague. Seen the moonshine over Brussels, strode back heaven's golden sands. And money's the happy hour we spent in Loch Gally's happy land. Oh, she's just a Kelty Clippy, she'll no tack ne advice. It's a crap deed, oh, bow your head, and I'll punch her ticket twice.
Our feather's just a waster, our mother's on the king. She's just a Celtic clippy, but I love her just the same.
Well, I met her on the 8:15, that night of romantic bliss. I said, say, Mag, put down your bag and gives a wee bit kiss. Well, she didn't take that kindly, no, she didn't like my chaff. And being a contrary kind of lass, she says, get off!
She has ni goat ni culture, she drives me round the bend. She sits every night in an old armchair, reading the People's Friend. Her lapels is full of badges, free butlins to the air, and she gets to the bingo every night with colour still in her hair.
She's just a Celtic clippy, she'll no dark near advice. There's a club deed to a bow, you need a punch up to get twice. Our feather's just a waster, our mother's on the game. She's just a Celtic clippy, but I love her it's just mental. The same.
Oh, but things is a wee bit better now. I've gone and got the ring. I won it by Davey at the pitch and toss last night at the Lindsay Bing. Wear wee black hat in a ticket machine, she did my hair and stare. She's a lily, all lumpy now, she's my bunny, Maggie.
Boston!
Just a Celtic clippy, she'll no take me advice. As I clap thee to a bow, you heed that I'll punch her ticket twice. Her feather's just a waster, her mother's on the game. She's just a Celtic clippy, but I love her just the same.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Watt and Davey Stewart.
What else is there? Finished totally.
What more can we say, folks? You've been lovely, all of you, every single one of you.
Tonight I am so happy. Tonight I am so gay. My mother's got a roly-poly pudding on the way. I saw her put the currants in the suet in as well. And you will be surprised at the story I will tell. I'm having a bit tonight, tonight. I'm having a bit tonight. My mother says I must be quick to get me bit of spotty day. I likes me roly-poly, it fills me with delight. I haven't had any since Christmas, but I'm having a bit tonight. Cha-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra. Cha-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra. My girlfriend's down for Easter and she's a lovely girl, her. Eyes are like the flashing stars and her teeth just like the pearls. There's only one thing wrong with her. She is so very fat. But tonight I'll give her spotty dick. Well, what do you think of that? I'm having a bit tonight, tonight. I'm having a bit tonight. My mother says I must be quick to get me bit of spotty dick. I likes me roly-poly, it fills me with delight. I haven't had any since Christmas, but I'm having a bit tonight. Her girlfriend, she came down with her, and she's a fat girl too. And everything what her girlfriend does, she always does it too. she takes a double helping. She's got such an appetite, but her ear's plenty spotted again. She'll be satisfied tonight.
I'm having a bit tonight.
My mother says I must be quick to get me better spotty dick. I likes me roly-poly, it fills me with delight. I haven't had any since Christmas, but I'm having a bit tonight. Ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Then there's Auntie Jessie, and there's Cousin Nell, and there is a girl next door, she likes a bit as well. Then there's dear old Grandad. I'd have thought he'd had enough, but Arrow is 94 years old. He's a bugger for his duff. I'm having a bit tonight.
My mother says I must be quick to get me bit of spotty dick. I likes me roly-poly, it fills me with delight.
I haven't had any since Christmas, but I'm having a bit tonight.
There you have it, John Watt and Davey Stewart.